Vasilievsky Island is the largest one in St. Petersburg. This very island was to become the administrative center of the new capital, as planned by Peter I. Merchant ships were to pass through the entire island via a wide canal from the sea to the spit. The Tsar divided the island by 400 rectangular sections intended for development of houses for distinguished citizens of Petersburg. Nevertheless, citizens did not move in a hurry to the new island, notwithstanding the menacing decrees of the Tsar, as there were no bridges and the low island was often flooded, but still, a lot was built there even during the reign of Peter the Great. Peter wanted to cover the entire island by a dense network and turn it into the sort of Amsterdam he had seen. However, this plan never came to fruition. Only few canals were dug, and even those had a short life. They were too narrow for ships, and finally citizens polluted them with the sewage. In 1770s, they, canals, were buried by the decision of the City Planning Commission. There are lots of legends connected with the name of Vasilievsky Island. Some historians claim that this name is associated with a certain man, Vasily Karchmin, gunner officer, who had his artillery battery to ward off the Swedish navy, and got Tsar's letters addressed to Vasily in the island. He was commemorated with a lively statue in the 7th line, the pedestrian street. The name might be a distortion of its previous Finnish name, because the island has been shown on maps before its present Russian history began after the Northern War. Finnish etymology may lead to a word Vasikasari, Calf Island. Another known Finnish name of the island was Hirvisaari, Elk or Moose Island.
Sundial is a device which tells the time of day and apparent position of the sun in the sky. It consists of the dial and gnomon, which cast the shadow onto the dial. As the sun moves across the sky, the shadow aligns with different hour lines, which are marked on the dial. Before the war, Vasily Pryanchnikov was a specialist in astronomy. In spring 1943, he created the sundial in Vasilievsky Island, in spite of the war and blockade. This sundial stood there until the end of war, and in 1945 it was dismantled. Leningrads checked here their watches and got them together to support each other. The idea to revive this sage relic was realized in 216. It is the memorial of the courage of Leningrad's residents. The project was developed on the basis of historical photography. On the 75th anniversary of the beginning of the blockade, the sundial was recreated.
St. Andrew's Cathedral. The late Baroque Cathedral was named after the Apostle Andrew, the patron saint of the Imperial Russia and its navy. Peter himself ordered to construct this church on the site. In 1732, a single-story wooden church was built, and the icon screen was taken from a chapel of a neighboring Menshikov Palace, but it was struck by lightning in 1761. 20 years later, the church was consecrated, and pyramidal bell tower attached to the church by a refectory was built in 1786 and remodeled in 1850.
The Cathedral of St. Andrews was closed after the revolution and given over to various organizations. During the siege of Leningrad, the cathedral was severely damaged. Thanks to the sharp thinking of members of the cathedral's congregation, the famous iconostasis, which had originally stood in the chapel of the Menshikov Palace nearby, was partly saved from the ravages of foreign revolution, carefully hidden behind false panel. Since 1992, the cathedral has been fully restored. In 2001, the obelisk was unveiled in front of the church.
Order of St. Andrew the First Call. The order is the highest order of the Russian Federation, established as the first highest order of the Russian Empire in 1698. It was abolished under the USSR and re-established as the top Russian order in 1998. The order was established in 1698 by Tsar Peter the Great in honor of Saint Andrew, the first apostle of Jesus and patron saint of Russia. It was solemnly awarded for the most outstanding civilian or military merit. The Burst of Admiral Golovin. Fyodor Alexeyevich Golovin was one of the nearest associates of the Peter I. He was a diplomat and statesman. His activity in the epoch of Peter's reforms was wide and varied. The States Chancellor, the General Field Marshal, the General Admiral, the President of the Ambassadorial Affairs, the Commander of the Navy Order, the Head of the Armory, Gold and Silver Chambers. In November 1698, Peter I established the first Russian order, the Saint Apostle Andrew the First called. Fyodor Alexeyevich Golovin became the first chevalier of the order. The legend says that according to the advice of Golovin, Peter I pointed the foundation Peter and Paul Fortest exactly at the mouth of the River Neva, to discontact the Swedish army during the Northern War. The monument was unveiled on the 6th of June in 2007.
The pharmacy of Dr. Pearl & Sons was founded in 1858 by Dr. Pearl. His business was quite successful. Even today people can buy medicines developed by him. But this doctor wasn't just a pharmacist, he was also an alchemist. One of the most famous in history, Dmitry Ivanovich Mendeleev, was a welcome guest in his house. According to a legend, Dr. Pearl played an important role in inspiring the famous periodic table of Mendeleev. In the yard of the pharmacy, there is Griffin's Tower. It is 11 meters high, 2 meters in diameter, it has no windows and doors, and his bricks are all numbered. There is a mystic story connected to this tower. It is said, some people think, that Dr. Pearl carried out his experiments here. They think he tried to breed griffins. That's why the tower got its name. But this is not the only mystic story. Another one is about numbers on its bricks. People say that the numbers change all the time, appearing and disappearing, and that in one particular moment they will line up in the code of happiness, or the universal code. And if someone appeared in front of the tower at this very moment, his wish would come true. The pharmacy still functions to this day. Ancient folios with the names in Latin and ampoules with medications from the early 20th century can be found here.
The garden establishment was started in 1768. It was designed for the needs of academic students. The new plan of the garden was made in 1847, that still exists. Initially, Alexander Brilov developed the plan of four pavilions in Greek, Persian, Egyptian and Roman styles, but only pavilion with Greek columns was made. The new roads and paths were paved and a fence was made. In 1817, a granite column appeared on the crossroad of the garden alleys. It was a spare part of the Our Lady of Kazan's Cathedral's colonnade. Architect Voronihin, the author of Kazan Cathedral, supposed to build the sphere on the top of the column. But it was replaced by a lion, the symbol of fine arts. The column was presented to the Academy afterwards to commemorate the anniversary of its foundation. In 1890, the new iron garden fence was made. In the southwestern corner of the garden, there is a battle workshop. Here students painted sketches of riding horses and riders. The garden of the Imperial Academy of Arts is connected with the name of Peter Claude. He is a famous sculptor and the author of Monument to Nicholas I, Monument to Krylov, and the Tremors of Anichkov Bridge. His foundry where he worked is on the left side of the garden.
Monument to Kosta Hitagurov. In 2009, there was unveiled the monument to Kosta Hitagurov in Fine Arts Academy Garden. He was called the Sitian Leonardo da Vinci because he was gifted with many talents. He was a poet, a writer, a playwright. He was a theatrical critic. He was a translator, an ethnographer, a musician, and a painter. In 1879-1883, he studied in St. Petersburg Imperial Academy of Art. Today he returned there the sculptor Vladimir Saskiev, the compatriot of Kosta Hitagurov.
Peter Karlovich Claude was born in 1805 in St. Petersburg. After he had graduated from the artillery school in St. Petersburg and a brief service, Claude, fascinated by molding and carving, devoted himself to sculpting. In 1830, he joined as a volunteer the Academy of Fine Arts. Later, Claude received a large government contract and together with sculptor Pimenov and Malinovsky participated in creating the sculptor group of horses of the Narva Triumphal Gate. Claude earned the European fame owing to the Dams of Horses, the ensemble of Anichkov Bridge, as under the order of Nicholas I, the sculptor group were sent as a gift to the Prussian king and to King of Sicily.
Claude was engaged with the creation of the St. Isaac's Cathedral. He created the reliefs and the sculptural group Christ in Glory above the holy doors of the chief iconostasis. During these years, the sculptor created the bas-relief St. George on horseback for the George Hall in the Grand Kremlin Palace in Moscow. According to a graphic sketch of Alexander Brilov, Claude made the 70-meter sculptural relief horse in the service of man for the office building of a marble palace. In 1849, Claude won the competition of projects of the monument to the Russian fabulist Ivan Andreevich Korolev to be set up in the Summer Garden. At the same period, Claude was working with a monument to Prince Vladimir of Kiev. The last major work by Claude was the equestrian statue of Nicholas I on the St. Isaac's Square. It has only two points of support, which is a rare engineering solution in the history of monumental sculpture. During almost 30 years, Claude headed the foundry house in the Art Academy garden, developing a number of improvements to the process of artistic casting. Sculptor Vladimir Gorivoy created the monument for the anniversary of Pyotr Karlovich Claude in May 2006. The sculptor created the bronze figure on his own initiative and at his own expense.
Is installed at number 13 at the second line of Vasilevsky Island, on the house where the Leningrad schoolgirl Tanya Savicheva kept her diary during the years of the siege. The diary consists of a few pages with brief notes, but these pages became known all over the world and served as an accusatory document against war and fascism during the Nuremberg trials. Was unveiled on 27th of January 2005, on the 61st anniversary of the complete liberation of Leningrad from Nazi siege. Although Tanya was rescued and transferred to a hospital, in 1844 she died because of tuberculosis. She was only 14.
The mosaic workshop of the Imperial Academy of Art was opened in 1851 to replace the painted icons of St. Isaac's Cathedral to mosaic ones. Since the mosaic art hadn't been used in Russia for about 100 years, and they needed to revive it, several Russian artists graduating from the Academy of Fine Arts were sent to Rome for training, and Italian Vincenzo Raffaelli arrived in St. Petersburg to open the mosaic workshop and smelt factory. In 1917 revolution, it was closed, and the mosaic workshop was reopened in 1922 as a department of monumental painting under the supervision of Frolov. Nowadays, the mosaic workshop is the unique one where is the full cycle of mosaic work to a plenty ceremony.